ॐ वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी, विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि, सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदं। वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वतीपरमेश्वरौ। येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। ॐ सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। Today, before we proceed further, I will share something and will request you to repeat after me that. We will not be discussing about that, what it is now. But it will be good if you keep chanting with me every class, and later we will see what it is, so that by the time what we are going to see, you will know it by heart, that one. That will be very useful later when we study the language and the grammar. Do you see the PowerPoint, what I'm sharing now, with only the heading?
Yes, Guruji.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, good. What is that written?
Maheshwara Sutrani.
Maheshwara Sutrani.
Yes, Maheshwara Sutrani. I will say, you just hear and repeat after me. We are not going to discuss about this now, but we will be chanting it every class. And the intention is, after some classes or before we enter into the particular topic, whenever the context comes, this will be very handy. You will know it by heart by then. So it will become very handy. That is why we are doing it as a part of our class. Every class we are doing, we are going to just chant. We are not going to discuss on that. Okay. Maheshwara Sutrani. What we are going to chant is the Maheshwara Sutrani. For this, you need to know only the letters, aksharas, the knowledge of akshara. Only that is required. Nothing else. So you can just make sure that there is no noise. There is no noise around you. Adjustment of your phone and your headphone. Yeah. There is some noise at your end. please make sure that there is no noise because you are going to repeat after me. Okay. Listen and repeat.
I won.
A e un a e u and nakara is there. So I'm chanting. Just hear and repeat. A e un.
A e un.
You can say a e un or a e un. Both same only. A e un.
A
e un.
Rulluk.
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 Aong.
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 I ouch.
I ouch.
Haya varat.
Haya varat.
Lun.
Lun.
Listen carefully. Nyamangananam. No? You're saying something. Listen to me. Nyamangananam. Letters with a consonant is there. Nya, you can say repeat after me. Nya.
Nya.
Ma.
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 Na.
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 Nam.
Nam.
I'm saying it together. Nya, ma, na, nam.
Nya, ma.
Nya, ma, na, nya, na, nam.
Jabhai. Now listen carefully and then repeat. Kha pha cha tha tha cha da tau. Kha pha cha tha tha cha da tau.
Kha
pha cha tha tha cha da tau.
Okay, I think you're saying something. Not saying what I'm saying. Kapai.
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 Shasha sar.
Shasha
sar.
Hal.
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 These are the 14 sutras. We will see what it is later. We will be chanting this every class. So, you please memorize this. It will be very useful later. Okay. Now we'll get to the class. You can mute your mic. See, if there is even slight, shake of your headphone or something you, where your laptop or keep and move and this, that sound also I can hear. So you have to make sure that there is no noise. Then only everybody can chant. And I can also hear comfortably. I have my headphone, so the noise is too much for me.
Om Gyaneshwara.
That's okay. I don't have to read that. It is for me. Okay. Now, in the last class, we saw, what did we see? We talked about Shabda. Remember? We talked about Shabda. Remember Shabda?
Yes,
yeah. From Shabda we derive Namapadam. Yes?
Yes,
Guruji. And we are discussing, going to discuss only about the Shabda, right?
Yes.
What is the gender of a shabda? How do you determine the gender of the shabda?
By the sound how it ends.
By the sound how it ends.
Suffix.
Did I say like that? By the sound.
Or suffix. Suffix.
The gender is determined by the suffix. No. How do you determine the gender of the gender of a shabda? What is a shabda? What is the translation of the word shabda? I think the notes.
The shabda's gender is independent of what it.
Very means. Good. That is what a shabda as gender. There is no way of you determining the gender of the shabda. You don't have any role. You cannot do because gender. The word has got gender. That's all. It has nothing to do with the meaning of the word, what it denotes. Nothing to do with the nature of what it denotes. A word as gender. And genders are three types, we know. Pullinga, Strilinga, Napumsakalinga. We are going to discuss about the Shabda now. I think up to that we saw in the last class, right? Shabda plus Pratyaya, we get Nama Padam, we saw. Padam means it's a technical word. What is the meaning? The English translation of the word Padam?
Word.
English noun form. Noun
word.
Form.
Noun form is noun a word. We use the word noun form. And Shabda is noun base. From the noun base, noun forms are derived. And we talked about from the noun base, from single noun base, how many noun forms we derived?
Nine.
No, not nine.
Nine.
Not 24. Nine. 24, good. 24. Because 8 cases are there. 8 into 3. Therefore, you get 24. And cases also we studied, right? We just discussed. Not studied, we just discussed. What cases? What do you mean by a case?
If a nama padam has a prepositional meaning.
Good. A case has got prepositional meaning. Therefore, the shabda with the pratyaya, the suffix, with the prepositional meaning, when you add, you get a nama padam. That nama padam has the prepositional meaning. The noun with the prepositional meaning. The noun form with the prepositional meaning is called a nama padam. Clear? Anyway, we are now going to discuss now shabda. First, we will start with shabda. Then we will get to Namapadam. We are not going to discuss Pratyaya now. Pratyaya is next level, another level of study. Not next level even, another level. Now we are going to discuss on Shabda, meaning noun base. And Shabdas are of three genders. Pullingaha, Trilingaha, Napumsakalingaha, that is neuter gender. We are going to discuss now. To start with, Pullinga Shabda. Pullinga Shabda. Okay. And I'm sharing a word file now. Just a minute. Now we are going to study Pullinga Shabda. You see the word file now? Masculine noun bases ending with vowels. Can you see that file?
Yes, Guruji.
Okay. This is what we are going to discuss. We are going to now discuss Shabda. We are going to discuss Shabda. Shabda meaning noun base. What noun base? Masculine noun base. Pullinga Shabda. And the Pullinga Shabda ends with what? Ends with vowels. A Shabda, meaning a noun base, can end with a vowel or a consonant. Right? A Shabda, meaning a noun base, it can end with a vowel or a consonant. But we are going to discuss only the Shabda ending with vowels now. We are going to discuss only the shabdas ending with vowels. Therefore, masculine noun bases ending with vowels is a topic. We are going to discuss the noun base, that is shabda, which are masculine, pullinga, and the noun base end with vowels. Therefore, ajanta. Ajanta means, remember, ending with vowel. Ajanta means ending with vowel. That is the meaning of the word ajanta. In fact, later you will be seeing how it has got that meaning also. You will see later. You will yourself will see. When you study a little Sanskritam, you will see. So ajanta is ending with vowel. That is the meaning. Pullinga, masculine. Shabdaha, noun basis. Now, in general, shabdas ending with vowels like a, e, u, r, a, o, au, they are considered to be pullinga, masculine. Forget about I, O, au. It is I, O, au. Forget about those three now, endings. We are not interested in that. We are interested only in the shabdas ending with the vowels a, e, u, and r. What are these four vowels? They are short vowels. Are they short or not?
Yes.
They are rasva. So now we are going to discuss shabdas, pullinga shabdas ending with short vowels. You can in general you can assume, to determine the gender, I'm saying shabdas ending with short vowel. Shabdas ending with short vowel can be masculine, can be pullinga. You can have some assumption to begin with. See, we always need some assumption, right? Otherwise, it's difficult. We assume, and then when we study further, when we get more knowledge, then based on our assumption, we study. And after studying, our assumption can be changed. When we gain knowledge, our assumption can be changed. We understand. Assumption is not a mistake. To start with assumption, and our assumptions gets refined when we gain more knowledge. That is what we are going to do. So to start with, you can assume that shabdas ending with short vowels are masculine. Nothing wrong in having this assumption to start with. Why I'm saying? Because there are exceptions. Exceptions are always there. Some shabdas which are short means ending with short vowels. Shabdas ending with short vowels, they could be feminine also. They could be neuter also. Anyway, those are exceptions. Exceptions are exceptions. Don't worry about it now. Now we will safely assume that shabdas ending with short vowels or masculine, right? Then how do we analyze a shabda? To analyze a shabda, you split the word into its individual constituents, letters. That is called varna vichedaha, splitting of the word into varna. Varna is letters. Varna vichedaha. And after doing the varna vicheda, you see the last letter of the word, shabda. Like, for example, now let us take the word. I'm typing in a word file. I hope you can see. I'm taking a word, Rama. Can you all see? I'm typing.
Yes, Guruji.
I'm taking a word, Rama. It's a good name. In the morning, we take the name of Lord Rama. Ramanama. The word Rama we are going to analyze. Rama is a Shabda. It's a noun base. So it is, what are the letters? Repa plus A plus Akara plus A. So what is the last letter of the Shabda Rama?
A.
A.
Always say A. Don't say Ma. Though you see Ma at the end. At the end of the Shabda. Ma is A. But Ma is what? Makara plus A. Ma is the combination of Makara plus A. So what is the last letter when I ask? You must say A. A is the last letter of the Shabda Rama. So therefore, Rama is a Shabda ending with the letter Akara. Yes or no?
Yeah.
And
yes. Good. Yes.
The word for ending is Anta. Antaha. The word for ending is Antaha. So Rama is a Shabda. I use the word Shabda. You understand Shabda. Shabda means noun base. Rama is a Shabda. You must understand the difference between Shabda and Padam. When I use Padam means noun form, refined word we get by adding the suffix to the noun base Shabda. So you understand when I use the word Shabda, Padam. Shabda, Rama Shabda is a is Rama Shabda, the word, the Shabda Rama ends with the letter A. So the word for ending is Antaha. Antaha means ending. Ends with the letter A, Akara. You know this Akara. So therefore, Rama is Akaranta. Akarantaha. It is Akaranta Shabda. Why? What is the meaning of Akaranta? Akaranta means that ends with Akara. That is called Akarantaha. Clear? Yes? Is it clear? Yeah. Akarantaha. Yeah. So Rama is a Shabda, ends with the letter A, therefore Akarantaha. So Akarantaha, what is the gender? What is masculine. Gender? Why it is masculine? Masculine? Because I told it ends with
short vowel.
Short vowel.
Short vowel.
So we are now studying with some assumption. If it ends with short vowel, it could be masculine. Pullingaha. So Akarantaha, that is Shabda is Akarantaha, ends with the letter A. And the linga is Pullinga. Pullingaha. The linga is Pullingaha. And the Shabda is Rama Shabdaha. Rama is the Shabda. Noun base, which is Pullinga, which is masculine, and which ends with the letter, short vowel, A, Akarantaha. So, this is the description of the noun base. Your noun base has to be described. We have to define the noun base. Describe the noun base. Akarantaha, Pullingaha, Rama, Shabdaha. It means Rama is a Shabda, noun base, which is a masculine gender Shabda, and which is the Shabda ends with the letter short vowel A. That is the meaning of the sentence. You understand the sentence?
Yeah.
Okay. Now we will see the file. We'll understand now. So, what did we do? We split the word Rama, the Shabda Rama, that is called Varna Vicheda. Then we analyze the end letter of the Shabda, Shabdanta. End letter we analyzed. It is A. Therefore, Akarantaha Pullingaha Iti. Now we are going to study the noun bases ending with the short vowel A. Let us examine the noun base Rama. Already we examined. Rama is equal to Repa plus A plus Makara plus A. The noun base Rama ends with the letter A. Therefore, it It is a masculine gender, noun base. It's clear. Therefore, Rama is akaranta pullinga. Akarantaha pullingaha Rama shabdaha. That is a description of the noun base Rama. It means Rama is a noun base ending with a. That's the meaning. Simple. Right? Okay. So, similarly, let us take another word. Ganesha. Ganesha is Gakara plus A plus Nakara plus A plus Shakara plus A. This we know. Already we studied in the beginning. The individual letters of the Shabda. What is the end letter of the Shabda Ganesha? A. Therefore, Akara Antaha. Then, and the gender is Pullingaha because short vowel. And the Shabda is Ganesha Shabdaha, which means Ganesha is a noun base ending with the letter A. So, Akarantaha, Pullingaha, Ganesha Shabdaha. Then, after that, I am giving a lot of example for Pullinga Shabda. Did we see this in the previous class?
No.
Okay. Now, I want you to define the noun base. I'll call you by Rama is a word. So, Rama is a word. Rama is a word. From Rama, we derive the noun form, Ramaha. See, you have to understand what is, if somebody asks a question, that's why I'm replying to that. Rama is a noun base. It's a Shabda. Now we are discussing Shabda. First you understand, we are discussing Shabda. What is a Shabda? Shabda meaning a noun base. From the noun base, we are deriving a noun form. So we are taking the word Rama, which is a noun base, which is not yet refined, which cannot be used in the language Rama, Iti. No, we cannot use it. We used to become, we have to add pratyaya, it suffix, then it will become a refined word. Therefore, Rama plus some pratyaya, some suffix, then becomes Ramaha, the word Ramaha. Okay, in Sanskritam. You may ask, we use the word Rama, Rama, is there in many places, is there in chanting and all, but do you know anything about the word, how the word came, how the word Rama came? Do you know whether the word is a noun base or noun form in a shloka?
Noun form.
It must be a noun form. It can't be a noun base. Even though you see the word Rama in a shloka, it is not a noun base. It is a noun form. It cannot be a noun base. Priyaji, understand?
Yes, Sri.
Isn't Rama a word? So why we call it noun base? Noun base is a word only. Why I'm using the word noun base? Why not I use the word itself, English word. If I use the word for Shabda, what will I use for the Padam? That also means word. Shabda means word. Padam also means word. So two different words having the meaning word, that will be confusing. That is why I use the word noun base. That's the reason why I use Shabda. If I translate Shabda as a noun base and a Padam as a noun form, then there is no confusion. Different names. Both are words only. But Padam, that is noun forms, can be used in the language directly. Can be used in the language. Whereas noun base, those are also words only. They can't be used because they are not defined. How do you define it? By adding suffixes. Then it becomes a noun form. To distinguish the two words, Shabda and Padam, I use two different names, noun base and noun form. Okay, clear?
Okay, Ji.
That must be clear because in the beginning I think I told, if I use the word for Shabda and Padam, it will be confusing. So you don't know what I mean. Do I mean the Shabda or do I mean the Padam? That is why I use noun base or noun form. Okay, now you know to define the shabda now. I did for Rama Shabda, I did for Ganesha Shabda. The same way, a lot of examples are there. We won't be able to read everything, but some words you can do. Now, Girijaji, you can take the first word in the table and you can define, describe the noun base. Girijaji, you can unmute your mic and read the
okay, Guruji.
First word.
Okay, okay, Guruji.
Yeah.
First one is Ramana, Refa plus
Akar. I don't want Varna Vicheda. You can describe the noun base.
Ramana is ending with Akara, the okay. short vowel. Mm-hmm. So this is Akaranta, Pullinga Shabdaha, Ramana, Pullinga Ramana Shabdaha.
Okay. Akarantaha, Pullingaha, Ramana Shabdaha. Okay, if you have difficulty in saying that in Sanskritam, I send Akarantaha, Pullingaha, Rama Shabdaha through that description of the Shabda Rama through WhatsApp. With okay. that, you can describe the same way you can describe the other Shabdas. The next person now. Priyaji, you can do.
Ji. Akarantaha pullingaha shiva shabdaha.
What is the meaning?
Shiva shabda ending with akara. So that is a pullinga gender.
Okay.
For the shabda shiva.
Yes. Next person, Prabhakarji.
Shankara. It's Akaranta, Pullinga, Shankara, Shabdaha.
Good. When you say, you should not drop the visarga. Akarantaha,
Akarantaha,
Pullingaha. Right? Okay. Then Shankara, Shabdaha, Shankara, Shabdaha. Shankara is a Shabda, masculine Shabda, Pullinga Shabda, ending with a short vowel. That is the meaning. Next person, Manjiriji. Next word.
Yes, Guruji. Akarantaha pullinga pullingaha mukunda shabdaha.
Akarantaha, yes.
Akarantaha pullingaha mukunda shabdaha.
Okay, next person. Manogaraji, next word.
Akarantaha. Pullingaha ara shabdaha.
Good. Next person now, Kirti. Just a minute, please. Can you please hold on for a minute? I'll come.
May God bless you with all prosperity, which will be healed. And you hear this, I offer this to Bhagavan and give the rest of the
Namaste, sorry. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah. Next person. Who is the next person? Shrutiji.
Yes, Guruji.
Yeah.
Akarantaha pullingaha vamana shabdaha.
Yeah, within bracket I have given the meaning of the word vamana. Vamana avatara, you know, right? Vamana,
yeah.
Short. Next person, Shrividyaji. Shrividya Shridhar.
Daridraha, Daridra, Akarantaha, Pullingaha, Daridra, Shabdaha.
Daridra, not Daridra.
Daridra, Daridra, Shabdaha.
Okay. Then, next person, Miraji.
Deva, Akarantaha, Pullingaha, Deva, Shabdaha.
Good. Lataji. Lataji can read. Unmute your mic and read.
Aja akaranta pullingaha aja shabdaha.
Akarantaha. Visarga is important.
Akarantaha pullingaha aja shabdaha.
Good. Nalini. Sure, sure.
Which one? Bala. Akarantaha pullingaha bala.
Bala shabdaha. Okay. Next person. Annapurna ji.
Akarantaha.
Akarantaha.
Akarantaha. Pullingaha. Nara shabdaha.
Yes. See, akarantaha. If you say akarantaha, the meaning is different. Short, not akaran, not akaranta, akaranta. A is short.
Akaranta, akaranta,
akaranta,
akaranta, akaranta,
akaranta.
Again, can you repeat again?
Akaranta.
No, no, no. It is not akaranta. Aka, akaranta,
akaranta.
Again.
Akarantaha.
That's correct. Okay. Can you describe again?
Yes. Akarantaha pulingaha nara shabdaha.
Nara shabdaha. Nara.
Nara shabdaha.
In my class here, in the Gurukulam, which I'm taking, many foreign nationals are there. I have found the same problem with them. When I say akaranta, they will say akaranta. But they are corrected now. They understood what it means. It's natural. It's common for them. I found the same thing, similarity in here also. Here. See, I asked them to read only in Sanskrit. Probably if I give the transliteration, they would be able to read properly, but I don't do that. I want them, once they are familiar with the Sanskrita script, must read with Sanskritam only. Not take the support of any other language, I mean English. Okay. Annapurna, do you want to ask anything? Raise your hand. Can unmute and ask question.
Thank you.
Okay, good. Next person now. Pradeep ji.
Akarantaha Lingaha Krishna Shabdaha.
Okay.
Krishna Shabdaha.
Krishna Shabdaha. It is Krishna Shabdaha. Not Krishna Shabdaha. It is Krishna Shabdaha. Krishna, the meaning changes. If you say Krishna, it is Draupadi. If it is Krishna, it is Lord Krishna.
Okay. Krishna.
And Krishna is Trilinga. Krishna is Pullinga.
Krishna.
So that Rasva Dirga is very important. When you read a word, I'm saying in general for everybody, it's Rasva and Dirga. When you read, that timing is important. Krishna. Vamana, not Vamana, or not Vamana.
Mana.
Vamana. Ma na va. Vamana. Right? Okay, next person. Mekalachi.
Balaka.
Akarantaha Pullingaha Balaka Shabdaha.
Okay, next person, Ram Kumarji.
Namaste Sharanji.
Namaste.
Rishabha. So Akarantaha Pullingaha Rishabha Shabdaha.
Okay, good. Next person, Nageshwarji.
Akarantaha Pullingaha Kaka Shabdaha.
Kaka, good. So you understand now, right? Akarantaha. All these are Akaranta Shabda. So many Shabdas are there. You can practice. Practice, at least when you read these words, you know the gender, you know the meaning. Gender, you know. It is all Akarantaha, Pullinga, but so many words are there. If you just read, you come to know. You know, there are a lot of words with meaning. You develop your vocabulary. It is for reading practice also. Maybe I will send this. You can practice. The next one. Next one, maybe another 5-10 minutes I will do. Then we'll stop. Next one, the next anta, the next ending is e. That is noun basis ending with e. That is ikarantaha. E is the anta. Short vowel e. Remember, short vowel e. So when you say, when you read the shabdas under this topic, remember it is e, not e. Hari, not hari. Okay. Hari is a shabda ending with the short vowel e. Therefore, e ikara. Therefore, ikara antaha ikarantaha. Ending with the short vowel e. Short vowel, therefore, pullingaha. Ikarantaha pullingaha. And the name of the shabda is Hari. Hari shabdaha. Ikarantaha pullingaha. Hari shabdaha. What is the meaning? Hari is a noun base, masculine noun base, ending with the short vowel e. This is the description of the noun base Hari. First we saw Rama. Now we are saying Hari. Rama is a sample. Sample Shabda. In the same way for all the Akaranta Pullinga Shabda. Similarly, Hari is a sample Shabda. So all Ikaranta Pullinga Shabda will be like Hari. Ikarantaha Pullingaha Hari Shabdaha. The format, this is the description I am sending through WhatsApp. You will receive it now. Now you can decline the other shabdas. You see a table. I'll call the names again. From the bottom, now up. Now Nageshwari, you can read the first word.
Kavi. Ikarantaha pullingaha kavi shabdaha.
Good. Next person, Ram Kumarji. If you are there, you can read. Ram Kumarji, are you there? Okay. Next person, Mekalaji, you can read.
I think he just left, Guruji.
Yeah.
Tandi.
Yeah.
Ikarantaha pullingaha Sandhi Shabdaha.
Good. Next person, Pradeep Kumarji.
Okay, Guruji. Ikarantaha Pullingaha Samadhi.
Samadhi Shabdaha.
Shabdaha. Shabdaha.
Okay. Annapurnaji, next word. You can unmute your mic. The mic to be unmuted. Annapurnaji, can you hear me? Okay. She's, I don't know whether she's there or not. The next person, Nalini ji, can read. Can you all hear me?
Yes, Guruji.
Yes. Okay. Nalini ji also is not there, I think. Lata ji, next person.
Yes, Guruji.
If they are leaving, better they send a message. Just leaving is not proper. Otherwise, the voice will recall them.
I'm here, Guruji.
I called your name. When I call your name, you have to unmute your mic and respond.
I didn't unmute it. That's what happened.
Yeah, yeah, you can read.
Udati.
Udadhi.
Udati. Arantaha. Pullingaha. Udati Shabdaha.
Again, please say again.
Ikarantaha.
Yes.
Pullingaha. Udati Shabdaha.
Udati Shabdaha.
Udati Shabdaha.
Yes, next person now. Nataji.
Ari Ikarantaha Pullingaha Ari Sabdaha.
Ari Shabdaha, not Sabdaha. Shabdaha.
Ari Shabdaha.
This is Ari is different from Hari. That is, Hari is Lord Vishnu, this Ari is enemy. When you say it wrongly, the meaning is different. Hari, Ari. Both are different. Okay, next person now. Next person. Who is next person?
Meera.
Meera ji, yes.
Yeah. Muni. Ikarantaha Pullingaha Muni Shabdaha.
Good. Next person, Srividya ji.
Kapi. Ikarantaha Pullingaha Kapi Shabdaha.
Good. Kirti, Shruti.
Panini, Panini, Ikarantaha, Pullingaha, Panini, Shabdaha.
Good. Manogarji.
Dasharati, Ikarantaha.
Ikarantaha, not Ikarantaha. Yeah. Short of Ikarantaha.
Sorry. Ikarantaha, the Pullingaha, Dasharati, Shabdaha.
Good. Manjariji.
Yes. Senapati.
Ikarantaha.
Yeah. Senapati.
Okay.
Ikarantaha Pullingaha Senapati Shabdaha.
Good. Prabhakar.
Upadhi limitation. Ikarantaha Pullingaha Upadhi Shabdaha.
Good. Priyaji.
Yes, Sri. Pani Ikarantaha Pullingaha Pani Shabdaha.
Good. Then Girijaji.
Yes, Guruji. Bali Ikarantaha Pullingaha Bali Shabdaha.
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 Okay. Shabdaha.
Okay, so now you have learned Shabdas ending with A and E. That is, you know to describe the noun base. You know to describe the noun base, but not the declension of the noun base. That's a big thing. We'll do it later, slowly. Now you can read a word, understand the gender, and describe the noun base. That is the beginning. That is the beginning of understanding the noun form, which we are going to do slowly. Noun base to be understood, then noun forms. Right? Okay. So we'll stop here.
Guruji?
Yeah.
Can I ask a question? Here, the word Rashmi.
Sorry?
It's Rashmi. There is one word Rashmi, the ray of light.
Mm-hmm.
It's according to this table, it's a male word, pullinga word. Mm-hmm. But if you see the name, Rashmi is the name of a female.
I told you, no, the word has gender. The word has gender, that's all. It has nothing to do with what it denotes, right? Okay. Rashmi is Suryasya Rashmihi, the rays of the sun.
Uh-huh.
And in the day of Rashmi.
No, Rashmi is usually the name of a female.
Yeah, I know. Yes.
Yeah.
I know people keep the name, but it is there.
It's a male word. Okay.
Yeah,
Shabda.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Rashmi is a good word. I mean, there are some words even in Tamil, you know, I know they, whether it's difficult to identify by the name, whether the person is male or female.
Uh-huh.
There is a person in our ashram in the reception. His name is Tangamani. You tell me if male or female.
It's a common name.
Tangamani is a
common name, both male and female.
Yeah, it's a common name. So we cannot make out the gender for the word. Tangamani is at first, she's a receptionist. And difficult. Some people are that name. Right? So it's okay.
So, Tangamani has some meaning?
Tanga means gold. Mani means the beads.
So, oh, okay. Tangamani. Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. We'll stop here.
Yeah.
Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. We are going at a slow pace, so you will feel comfortable in picking up.
Yeah.
So Sanskritam without tears.
Yeah.
Namaste.
Dhanyavad Guruji. Thank you so much. Dhanyavad.